They did.
Meeting what?
You're not gonna put Ms. Anthony on?
No, we're not.
Well, let's get this jury out of here, and then we will hear motions for judgment of acquittal. Let's return the jury.
Okay, the jury coming back into the courtroom real quick. Judge Perry asked the defense, were they going to put Miss Anthony up? Did he mean Casey? Did he mean Cindy? We believe it's Cindy Anthony, but the answer is no. So the jury's back in. We'll see what Judge Perry instructs. Let's go back to Orlando.
Stay recognized, President of Jury.
Yes,
defense.
Yes, sir, we do.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, this concludes the presentation of all evidence. We will convene on Sunday at 9 a.m. for closing arguments and instruction on the law in this case. Please remember all of my previous admonitions. Any additional instructions on behalf of the state?
Your Honor.
Or the defense?
Nothing from the defense.
Members of the jury, you may be excused. Mr. Mason.
Your Honor, this time the defendant wishes to renew the several previously made motions. One, the motions that we have made for mistrial, particularly, and not waiving any, but particularly the one regarding the introduction over objection of the video superimposition of photos predicated with Dr. Warren. You know exactly?
Yes.
Okay. Renewing the motion for mistrial on that. I also...
Renewed motion for mistrial will be denied.
I also wish to raise again...
All right. Special report coming up next as we listen to the defense and we are winding down toward closing arguments. You're watching HLN. Stay with us.
Medicare. It doesn't cover every...
In both parties, we owe...
United Healthcare Insurance Company. All Medicare supplement insurance plans can help pay some of what Medicare doesn't, so you could save thousands of dollars in out-of-pocket expenses. Call now for this free information kit and Medicare guide. If you're turning 65 or you're already on Medicare, you should know about this card. It's the only...
want to come.
Tonight, a huge development in the Casey Anthony murder.
You know, they'll make good reading for somebody someday. The fact of the matter is that Dr. Sigmund took the air from the trunk of the car, got two Tedlar bags, sent one to Dr. Voss, and took one for himself. And his primary ingredient was gasoline with a trace of chloroform. And Body Farm Dr. Voss, chemist Dr. Wise, said that there. The biggest spike they had was chloroform, but no quantitative analysis. So the whole thing is just a bunch of confusion. Was there a chloroform in the trunk? Maybe, in amount, no different from the atmosphere. Was there evidence that the child was killed by it? No. Is there speculation? Yes. So if you separate the facts from fiction and inferences being stacked on inferences, this is really not something that should result in guessing by a jury. They shouldn't be burdened to have to guess something like this. You can take the burden. You're used to it. That's your job. And your burden, I suggest respectfully, is to say you're right. This does require inference on inference, guessing, speculation. But there is no proof as to when, who, and how the child died. And I urge you to enter a judgment of acquittal as to counts 1, 2, and 3.
Thank you, Mr. Mason. State response?
Just briefly, Your Honor. Mr. Mason is arguing factual matters that are more properly resolved by a jury, and it is our position that the jury should be the body that makes the decision as to what is indeed fact and what is fiction. As a legal matter, as argued at the close of the state's evidence, there is sufficient evidence to go to the jury on each of the charges as charged, and we would urge the court to deny the judgment of acquittal on that basis. The defense during their case having presented no new hypothesis of innocence.
Anything else, Mr. Mason? Renewed motion for judgment of acquittal will be denied. Okay, what time do y'all want to meet on Sunday?
The court suggests 8:30 to finalize jury instructions. That'll be fine. We'll have a telephone conference at noon tomorrow. Good for everybody?
After you get up?
Does that mean I can sleep till 11:55? That's pretty good.
We'll get the card as best we can work out amongst ourselves. With your standards and the fire preparing all the ones out there.
Mr. Mason, you need to turn on the microphone.
This one, right?
Go ahead.
We're going to be able, I think, to work out just about all that we will need your intervention
as to the theory of defense instruction and maybe one special just to ask and indicate he was writing, going to do some special. But the rest of it, I am certain we will go through the myriad of standards. We've been working on that. I'm sure that the same is yours.
Based on Arizona versus Shad and that concept, and I'll send it to you first thing tomorrow morning, okay. around 10, I guess that's not really first thing. But we can discuss it at noon.
Do y'all remember the murder of Judge Chillingworth?
Yes, I
do. Did they ever? Huh? Did they ever find his body? Did they ever find his body, Mr. Mason?
No, they never found his body, but they found blood all in the back of the boat. Now this is going back a long time. This is back in the 70s.
Mm-hmm.
And
he went fishing and didn't come back.
Fishing and not coming back.
Mm-hmm.
Travesty.
Okay. All right. Court will be in recess.
How about that? Closing arguments Sunday, 9 a.m. All the evidence is in now in the case against Casey Anthony. Look at her. Her head is down. And I see this a lot in criminal defendants when you're at that point where you realize it's no longer in your hands. Your attorneys can do very little at this point. There is no more evidence. 12 people that you never met are going to decide the rest of your life. She's having a hard time right now. Let me bring in all the all-stars that we have with us tonight. Jane Velez Mitchell, host of Issues, which is coming up at 7 tonight. Ryan Smith, host of In Session on True TV. Beth Karras, correspondent for In Session on True TV. Mike Brooks, HLN law enforcement analyst.
Part of America. I didn't even try to open a business.
Jane, Casey Anthony at this moment looks a little different than we've ever seen her now that all the evidence is in, Jane.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You said that right, Vinny. Her head, now she's looking up, but just moments ago, I think we all saw it, her head was hanging down, and the juxtaposition between the attorneys, giddy with enthusiasm at the prospect of seeing the light at the end of the tunnel, and this grueling case is almost over, and they're talking about fishing, and they're literally giddy with excitement, and she is going into the depths of what you might call reality, coming out of sometimes that fantasy world that she lives in, that everything's going to be okay. And this is a moment, I think there is fear. I think that woman is experiencing tremendous fear right now because she is helpless. This is a girl, young lady who likes to control, and she has no control.
Not anymore, Ryan. Yep. I mean, closing arguments is another moment where you can say, yeah, that's what really happened here. My lawyers will explain. Here she is turning around. She looks a little frantic right now.
She does. And you know, I think it's all hitting home. She actually looks upset right there, like she's talking to her lawyers about a few things. But this is the point where it all hits home. And I think you look at a case like this, you know, everybody else in that courtroom, the jury, the judge, the lawyers, everybody will go home after this case is over. The only person who might not go home is Casey Anthony. So when you have those moments, once the evidence is in, closing arguments are about to start, you as a defendant are sitting there saying, what happens next? What's going to happen after closing arguments and then a jury decides my fate? And we're talking life and death here.
Very animated at the end there, and interesting to watch her. But that is the moment, and it happens in every trial. But for a criminal defendant, think about it.